Let's use Hurricane Cleo. Now, I just want to use this as an extreme situation just to talk to you about what land does to these tropical systems. Back in 1964, we had Hurricane Cleo passing in the same area with winds of about 150 miles an hour. Watch what happens as soon as it interacts with Hispaniola. The winds go all the way down to 115 miles an hour just from skirting Hispaniola. And then by the time it makes its way off the northern tip of Cuba, we have a minimal hurricane with winds of 75 miles an hour. That being said, by the time Cleo made it up to South Florida, Palm Beach County, it made it up to 100 miles an hour. So the bottom line is this land is going to have a major influence. We think it'll keep the system weak, if not tear it apart completely. But if it makes it off of Cuba, moving towards South Florida, there's a narrow window here with very, very warm water that could give this system an opportunity to strengthen. Of course, we have to watch it very closely. Just wanted to share that with you.